Hello, my name is Noah Ostler, but you can call me Noah. I'm a filmmaker. I've worked on a number of projects you might recognize. You know the very professional interview series, Between Two Trash Cans? Yeah, that was me. In February of 2017, I went to a student talent show at a college called Principia. The talent show was titled something like Starbucks, like the popular coffee brand Starbucks. Don't worry, I don't really get it either. In any case, that night, I heard a band that for me redefined the word a cappella. I was blown away by their humor, their energy, and more than anything else, their lack of a conventional beat. That was Principia College's very own minus one. 2 years and four performances later, Minus One was on the verge of becoming more than just a campus-wide attraction. And when I heard that they were dropping their first album, I practically jumped at the chance to make the documentary, if you will, the mockumentary that you're about to see. I set out on a mission with my cameraman, John Woodall, to capture the sights, the sounds, the tastes, the essence of a hardworking a cappella group. And I got that, but I also got a whole lot more. What you're about to see is a film about love, friendship, sex, and rock and roll. Well, not so much the sex part, but I'm getting ahead of myself. In any case, enjoy the film. I've got a cow to milk. Hit it!
Okay. Do you have a name? Hello? Do you have the short ties? Those you guys?
We are the self-proclaimed worst a cappella group on campus. Minus one.
The energy in the music is questionable.
When I think about Minus One, I think about their goofy outfits.
They have this misplaced confidence. Why? Attractive? No, not in the slightest.
How can someone that pitchy be attractive?
The beatboxer's all right.
Who? Dumb name. Dumber outfits.
They're complete losers.
Dumbest music.
John Murphy brought with Riley on the cliffs of all their knee. He took out his shillelagh and he stabbed him in the spleen. Thought he was a leprechaun, but in fact he's just a leper and his heart's a leprechaun. When Timmy Johnson broke his neck, it was a crying shame. He wasn't really Irish, but he went to Notre Dame. Eric crossed the street and by a bus was eat, but he was just a Scotsman, so nobody give a
shit.
What got you guys into music performance?
Well, to speak for all of us, I'd say it's first and foremost about the fame.
You know, I love being able to walk down that street and know that what I do, it is art. And because of that, people praise us.
Yeah, and you know, like, there's the people that do the music and then the people that listen to the music. And you know, we're really on that first half of the spectrum because it really is a spectrum, right?
What we do,
Mm-hmm. Exactly. See, there's a difference between us and everyone else because there are people who think that they got it, but they don't actually get it. Lucky enough, we all got it, and we get it. Got it?
Yeah, I think I got it.
But see, that right there's the problem. It's that you think that you get it, but you don't actually got it. But we got it. Get it?
I don't get it.
And where exactly did the name come from?
Minus one. I came up with it. What he's trying to say is that it's a play on words. There's the other a cappella group on campus. What's the name again?
Plus one.
Right, and so we tried to pull a fast one on them. I guess one up them a little bit.
If you were gonna one up plus one, shouldn't you be plus two?
Guys, that's not a bad idea.
No, see, we aren't about that lifestyle, are we, boys? What plus one does is hosh and posh, and minus one's about having fun. I hate everyone in that elitist group.
Nathan, aren't you in plus one?
Yeah.
I mean, you're not really in plus one, are you, Nate?
Well, I mean...
To answer your question, Noah Ostler, can I call you Noah?
Sure.
Okay, Noah Ostler. To answer your question, I came up with a name.
All right, what I was thinking here is that everyone knows who we are, but no one knows who we aren't. And because of this paradox, I believe that our album should be called We Are Not Plus One.
Okay, subtle. Thanks, Steve. All right, quick recap. Sean suggested Lightning Never Strikes Once. I suggested Floppy Pickle Puncher. Mitchell came up with Lemonade Nipple. Let's see what else. Pyetha gave us Naked Vomit Sticks. Ryan blessed us with, if you can't a bitch, then just and Cam gave us an album cover. And Steven just showed us We Are Not Plus One. Does anyone have anything to say before we take a vote?
I'd like to preface this voting by reminding all of you exactly who started the band.
I think Lemonade and Nipple works on a variety of different levels.
We Are Not Plus One is a true statement.
It's not very good.
What else wasn't very good? When you wanted to sing My Shiny Teeth in Me?
Yeah, Mitchell, you cold bowl of soup looking
I came up with the band name!
Hey, let's just take a vote, alright? The two with the least amount of votes are off the table. Alright, so who likes Lightning Never Strikes Once? Alright, one. Alright, and how many for Floppy Pickle Puncher? Okay. It's tied. Anyone like Lemonade and Nipple?
The worst one.
How many people here are just going to, like, vote for their own?
Think anyone in the group has any problems right now?
No, I don't think there are any problems, really. Because when I think about minus one, I think about, like a really good pie. And when you have a good pie, it works. But, you know, sometimes you get a bad pie. And when it's a bad pie, it's a bad pie. And a bad pie is made by a bad chef. But I'm the head chef. So, I'm sure you know what I mean.
Yeah, I do. But you don't think anyone in the group has any problems with you being the leader, right?
No. I don't think they really care.
Do you have any problems with the band?
Definitely, Sean.
Sean never listens to other people.
Of course he called himself the head chef.
Are you sure you don't want to cover up a little bit?
What's that?
Sean is just a take it up the Kia Sorrento loving mother asshole.
Do you have anything to say, Cam?
There might be some dissonance with the group, but that's just the business.
And do you think that Sean's a good leader?
As his co-leader? I mean, I'm sure he mentioned that. We kind of like balance each other out, you know? Like, if he gets too crazy, I'm like, whoa, Sean, don't do that. And then if I get too crazy, he's like, get out of here, Nathan. And it's really just like a system, you know?
No, I wouldn't say that I love having all the power. I certainly need all the power for myself. But love as a word just sounds too wishy-washy, you know? What I do, it's fierce,
it's sexy, and above all else, it's just honest.
Your voice sounds different.
What voice?
Yeah, no, I'm really sure, actually. You didn't have an accent a minute ago, and now you do.
No, I don't.
It's like Australian or New Zealandish.
You mean my rock star voice?
Your rock star voice?
Yeah, every great has one. Like John Lennon, Elton John, John Denver, John Washington, you know, all those people.
Are you lying to me?
Nah, just look it up. On the Google.
Carson, you were part of the original cast.
Yes, I was.
Why'd you quit?
I did the first two performances. The first went over pretty well. The second harshly declined in quality. I could tell the ship was sinking, so I bailed. Honestly, I'm glad I got out when I did.
And what are your feelings on the band's current state?
It's a hot mess. Pitch is all over the place. The song choice is horrible. The costumes are tragic. Honestly, I just feel bad for Nathan. He could be doing so much better with his actual talent.
Do you have any thoughts on their upcoming album?
If they ever decide on a name, then maybe we'll talk.
Michael, what led you to leave Minus One?
I don't know. I just wasn't really feeling it, I guess.
It had nothing to do with the incident.
What incident?
Incident isn't why I left. I made one mistake, forgot a few words, big deal. Everyone was just an asshole about it, so I left.
Would you ever consider rejoining the group?
I'd think about it if everyone apologizes to me. And I've gotten personal apologies from everyone in the group except for one. And I bet you already know who that is.
Costuming is an important part of our artistic process. Cultivating our style takes a long time, but I'm sure you already know that.
Ocean man, take me by the hand, lead me to the land that you'll understand. Ocean man, the voyage to the corner of the globe is a real trip. Ocean man, the crust of a tan man and by the sand, soaking up the thirst of the land. Ocean man, can you see through the wonder of amazement at the overman? Ocean man, the crust is elusive when it casts forth to the childlike man. Ocean man, the sequence of a life form braced in the sand, soaking up the thirst of the land. Ocean man, take me by the hand, lead me to the land that you'll understand. Ocean man, the voyage to the corner of the globe is a real trip. Ocean man, the crust of a tan man imbibed by the sand, soaking up the thirst of the land. Ocean man.
All right, guys, that one sounded great.
Yeah!
Yeah. Oh, All right, calm down. That's only the third song we finished. What's up next?
The place where he was born and raised.
And sorrow, I've seen trouble all my days. I bid farewell to old Kentucky, the place where I was born and raised.
The place where he was born and raised.
For 6 long years I've been in trouble. No pleasures here on earth I've found. For in this world I'm bound to ramble. I have no friends to help me now.
He has no friends to help him now.
Sean, what the hell's the problem?
Why'd you say that?
Say what?
You heard me.
You mean the lyrics to the song?
Are you f***ing
You know something to say? Say it to my face!
Fellas, I gotta tell you, this isn't working for me. I gotta have more cowbell.
Sean.
What do you see this album doing for the band?
I think this is a great opportunity for the band. I mean, I've been writing all the music, recording the tracks, and running all the practices, and yeah, it's just turning into a great piece of musical comedy.
Yeah. Yeah, Nathan's been doing a great job with all that. But I think the album and the more serious direction I've been pushing the album could really open up some exciting career opportunities for myself. Maybe some lead acting roles, some directing work? I don't know. We'll see, you know?
Yeah. Same for me, too. Hopefully.
Check this out.
Can you put it right now? Can you put it up inside?
Pretty great, right? It's actually just me and Sean goofing off.
It's certainly unique.
Yeah. That was back when Sean and I came in here and kind of just messed around. Anyway, let me show you this one. You know what? I actually can't really show you that one. Ooh, check this one.
Have you and Sean always collaborated on projects like this?
Like I said, we used to. He doesn't really like it when I do it anymore. He says
it's a bloody waste of time.
I don't know. I don't really do it anymore. Here, come on, let me show you how this stuff works.
Stop, 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 stop.
Please stop that.
Couple good ideas over the years. I've suggested we sing My Shiny Teeth and Me multiple times. No one listens. I had a good idea one time to do a music video to the song Fighting Fartin, and that was vetoed again. I had this brilliant idea one time to do a sexy car wash for charity, and everyone complained about the cold and said no.
Mitchell, do you feel undervalued?
Undervalued, underappreciated, whatever you want to call it. I'm just not given the time of day. No one listens.
Not a word? Okay.
Of course there's fucking tension. Have you not been paying any attention to any things that have been going on in this fucking band with any of these assholes? Stop censoring me, I'm not swearing. Have you any of you been paying attention, you
really sorry to hear that. I was talking more about the tension between Nathan and Sean.
But who gives a rat's ass about any of that. Why are you like this? I'm trying to get comfortable.
Can we just start without him?
He's the lead goddamn singer. He wants to keep a harmony for no one?
I just wanted to do something, idiot.
Why doesn't someone else sing lead? Why is he always the lead now?
I'm sure he'll be here any second.
It's been 45 minutes, there has to be consequences.
I agree.
Are we gonna kick Sean out of the band?
All in favor?
Aye.
We can't do this unless it's for the good of the band. It has to be unanimous.
Aye.
Aye, for the good of the band.
What is?
Nate, why is everyone hanging around? Well, let's go. Nate, get him up.
Sean, we took a vote.
That's nice. Let's go.
You're out.
You guys, oh, what a joke. No, but seriously, let's get in there and sing, guys.
How dare you use that word?
Sean, we took a vote. You're out of the band.
How did Cam vote? He can't even speak! He's a mute!
I can speak, you moron. This is an a cappella group.
You can't kick me out of my own group.
You're not even in this band anymore. You're just an asshole. You need to leave. We've got work to do.
I saw this going, I want to be kicked, you guys, you know, this band is stupid. You guys are stupid. Oh, and Mitchell?
What?
You know that brownie I gave you last week?
Yeah.
Yeah. I picked it up off the floor. The bathroom floor.
Was it hard?
It had to be done. It wasn't working. Sean just literally brought the whole group down. Is there anything else I have to say?
Have you spoken to him recently?
Essentially? Yeah.
What do you mean?
Well, I was in the hallway and I said, hi.
And what did you guys talk about?
And he kind of just kept on walking. It kind of seemed like he needed to get somewhere. Well, I know lunch was closing pretty soon. So yeah, I guess it kind of was on the brief side of things.
How's the band doing?
I think the guys are all doing well. They seem to be stepping up and filling the void. Not like there's a void that needs to be filled. And they're definitely all getting along better, which is great. And at the end of the day, we're all getting the job done, and I think we're proud of the work we've been doing. It's just been so great. No worries.
Good work today, guys. It's such a good day. Yeah. Oh, okay. How about a yeah? Good work. Hey. Nice work, dude. Okay. All right. Job right.
How are you guys doing?
We kicked him out.
I came up with the band name.
It's been pretty good. You know, it's been a little bit different, and we still need a little bit of time to adjust, but we're still producing some pretty good stuff.
F***ing hell, I need a corn dog.
We literally just ate.
No, you just ate, you fat f***. I was too busy s***ing my brains out over that dinner you made last night.
What did you just say?
I said,
guys,
I was too busy.
Saying it again is not gonna help anything. You guys are acting like a bunch of morons.
I agree. Guys, I got an idea. Okay, so what if we cut down every single tree in the world, and then, you know, global warming will start happening, and then Sean, will, he's, you know, he's a smart guy, right? So he'll come up with an idea to, like, save the world, and then he'll
what
come back
hell?
And
the-
Yeesh.
Attachment issues, am I right?
Shut up, Bitchel.
Yeah. Hey, guys. Come on in. You want vodka? Just kidding. This is vodka. We're not allowed to drink. You know that. I know why you guys are here. You want my thoughts on their single that's gonna drop this week. You're probably wondering how I know they're dropping a single. It's because I've been stalking them really avidly. But the thing is, I don't care about the band anymore. They kicked me out. I'm done. Please leave me alone. Alright, is that good enough footage for the documentary? Alright, let me show you what I've been actually working on. This right here is my voodoo station. So, for instance, this is me.
This is Nathan.
That's Mitchell with the glasses. That's Steve. That's Ryan. That one's Pyetha, obviously. And that one's Cam. What I can do with this voodoo station is control their every movement. So, for instance, the single that drops tomorrow, I can pick up Nathan and go like this. And no more single. Where are you going?
Somebody once told me the world was gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kinda dumb, her finger and her thumb in the shape of an L on her forehead. Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to the rules and I hit the ground running. Did make sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart, but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see. So what's wrong with taking the back streets? You'll never know if you don't go.
It's not too bad.
Yeah, they sound alright.
It's a bit pitchy.
Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid. And
it's not funny at all.
They record stuff now? I can do that.
Well, Nathan did his best.
Do it.
They f***ing hate us.
They do not hate us.
They don't love us.
Well, minus one clearly reflects some musical potential. All of it is wasted in the single that not only shows a lack of focus, but a lack of identity. The jury is still out on the album as a whole, which drops later this month, but as of now, the band may want to consider themselves minus one fan.
What does that mean?
It means we're done for.
No, guys, relax.
So what? We made a dud. Who gives a crap? Come on, we'll just go back in the studio tomorrow and we'll make something that's better than anything that anybody has ever heard. So what? They hate us. That doesn't change us. We're all still here. We're all still in this thing.
Not all of us.
Well, anything can happen. If there's a will, there's a way.
Oh, hey, didn't see you there. Great job on the song, boys.
Well, get the hell out of here.
If you say so. Chef one forever.
I'm chef number one.
What? This is f***ing ridiculous.
Pete.
Are you good?
Yeah. I think I just... Never mind. Forget it. I think it's fine.
Guys, I got an idea.
Shut up, Mitchell.
We'll just meet tomorrow, okay? Same time. Just be prepared to make something great. Alright, guys, so we're down to two again. It's between Laminated Nipple and Lightning Never Strikes Once, which you don't have to vote for. Sean's not even here.
Well, I feel bad for him.
I voted him out of the band. I owe him.
Anyway. How many for Lightning Never Strikes Once? Okay, and how many for Lemonade Nipple? Great. Another tie.
I still have a vote? Look, guys, I'm sorry for being such a control freak. You know, I'm just a super insecure dude who tries to mask it with awesome accents and sick vocal shreds and... There I go again. All I'm trying to say is, you guys don't suck without me. But I suck without you. I miss you.
Bullshit!
Mitchell, I'm voting for your cover over mine. Do you want me in the band or not?
You suddenly make a compelling argument.
all in favor of voting me back in the group?
Aye.
Look, buddy, I'm sorry. You're much better at this than me. You should take the lead from now on.
Aye.
So, what do we do now?
The place where he was born and raised
for 6 long years. I've been in trouble. No pleasures here on earth I've found. For in this world I'm bound to ramble. I have no friends to help me now.
He has no friends to help him now.
Hey.
Chef number one.
What's going on here?
Oh, Ethan. You'll find out soon enough.
Pete, are you good?
Yeah, I think I just... Never mind. Forget it. I think it's fine.
Hello!